Jenny took out her phone. It took her less than 2 minutes to find the address of Dr. Mackenzie's surgery. It was a short drive away, and a few minutes later, Jenny was parking across the road from the surgery, a detached bungalow that had once been a family home. The garden had been paved over to make a car park, and there was a large sign saying, "Doctors only. All other cars will be clamped."
"I'll do this one," said Nightingale.
"That's good, because I think I've passed my quota of untruths today," said Jenny. Nightingale climbed out of the car and lit a cigarette. Jenny wound down the window and looked up at him. "Seriously? You're going to go in there smoking?"
"No, I need a cigarette. I'll smoke it, then go in."
"You should try patches," she said.
"I can't get them to light," he said.
He took a drag on the cigarette and walked across the road to the surgery. Through a window, Nightingale could see half a dozen people, mainly pensioners, sitting on wooden chairs and beyond them a reception area. He took a final pull on his cigarette and then flicked it towards a drain before pushing open the door. He walked across a tiled floor to the reception. Two middle-aged women were sitting at desks, staring at computer terminals, while another woman was on the phone, explaining why it wasn't possible for the caller to have an appointment the following day or the day after. Nightingale stood and waited. The two women stared at the computer screens, and he got the impression they were deliberately avoiding eye contact. To his right was a corridor that presumably led to the consulting rooms. There was a digital sign above the corridor that gave the name of the last patient and the number of the room they were to go to. Nightingale figured it saved the reception staff from having to talk to the patients.
"Because all our appointments are full," explained the woman on the phone. "The day after tomorrow is the best I can do."
There was a brief pause, then the woman spoke again.
"Well, I'm sorry you feel that way," she said. "You can always try A&E.
To the left of the reception area, there were framed photographs on the wall of the four doctors who worked for the practice. Dr. Ron Mackenzie was on the far right. He was in his 50s with grey hair, round spectacles and a kindly smile. According to the brief notes under the photograph, he had been with the practice for 10 years and specialised in young patients.